Hey guys, a short while ago I made a tutorial about Pandas AI. Pandas AI lets you ask your data frame questions and the AI will give you the answers. That is pretty cool. But wouldn't it be even cooler to know how the AI figured out those answers? This made me look into another great library called Sketch. Sketch not only lets you ask your data frame questions, it even gives you the actual Pandas code. Let us take a quick look at how it works. First off, you need to install it. Just type pip install sketch in your command prompt or terminal. Once that's done, you can import it along with pandas. Next, for the sake of our demo, I will load some sample data. But instead of me explaining this dataset to you, let's ask the AI. On your data frame, you can use sketch.ask and then ask your question. I asked the AI what this dataset is about. The AI tells us that the dataset is about customer purchases and has the following columns. Next, I want a simple name and a short description for every column. I also want the output as an HTML list. Just like that, I get the result I want. This can be pretty useful, for example, when you encounter column headers with abbreviations that you might not know about, such as cost of goods sold. Next, I thought it would be fun to ask the AI what kind of analysis could be interesting. You can find some very cool ideas this way. There are some obvious calculations we could perform, like looking at how the sales amount changes across different branches or products, or group the sales by month. But Sketch also suggested looking into some other interesting relationships. Now, here's the fun part. You can ask the AI to show you how to do these steps in Pandas. So let's say I want to see how the weighting relates to the total sales. I would like to know if higher sales go with higher or lower weightings and vice versa. Now we don't actually have a total sales column. The column name is just total, but that is not a problem. When I run the cell, I get a suggestion. I can copy this code and paste it into a new cell. Running this cell gives me a scatter plot, which is really cool. It even added comments for the different steps and put in the X and Y labels as well as a title. As we can see, there's no clear link between the weightings and total sales. We can double check this by commenting out the plot and just printing out the correlation, which is very close to zero. Next, I want to figure out how to calculate the product lines with the highest profits. But we don't have a profit column. We actually need to create it first. But as we can see, Sketch did that calculation for us. Let me copy the code, paste it into a new cell, and run it. We now have a new data frame showing the top 5 products with the highest profit amounts. As we have seen, you can do more than just calculations. You can also use Sketch to create plots. So I'm going to ask it to plot total sales by gender. And like before, I get the Python code. I also want to plot sales by month. This one is a bit more tricky because you first need to change the date column to get the month and then group the sales accordingly. By default, the AI uses matplotlib for the plots. But if you want, you can be more specific like I did here. Here I ask how to plot total sales by each hour of the day using plotly. Like before, this actually needs a bit of data wrangling, as we can see here. But when I copy and run the code, we get our interactive plotly chart. We can now see the sales grouped by hour. Now, you might be wondering how this works. Looking at the GitHub repo, we see that the data gets summarized and sent to a large language model. You might want to keep this in mind, especially if you are working with sensitive company data. In Pandas AI, the data was randomized before it was fed into the AI. Regardless, I think this library looks very promising. There are a few more functions that I didn't talk about in this video. I would encourage you to check out the GitHub repo yourself. I will upload this notebook to my GitHub repo as well, in case you want to play around with the data. You will find the link in the description box of this video. And as always, thanks for watching, and I will see you in the next video.